Okay, good evening friends. Today we are going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is the applications of the biotechnology, right? That's a very important one, we know very well. We can expect the one marker question also, even we can expect the two marker question also. And friends, this is the details about the new course, right? Right. And friends, biochemistry series is going to be started in the free classes, whomever interested, you can easily attend over there, right? Yes. And this is the information about the GATB full length test, that is on 10th and 24th July. Please kindly utilize this particular test, which are absolutely free. And these are all the crack jam test, right? Which is absolutely free, okay? And this is the test about the adjust, this is exclusively for the physics. Yes. Okay, friends, try to understand what is this particular biotechnology and its applications. We have to know it very well. Just give me a moment. Just a moment, friends. Just a moment. Yeah. So friends, let's try to understand briefly and elaboratively by biotechnology as well as its applications. So friends, we know, right, nowadays, even in the olden days, biotechnology having a significant applications even in the medicine also, even in the agriculture also. So friends, even after the green revolution, many of the techniques came into the existence, but biotechnology is one of the major field where it is having a significant applications even in the medicine as well as in the agriculture. So biotechnology can be widely used in the environment, food industry, chemical industry, medicine, agriculture, power industry also, right? Friends, now try to understand what kind of products that we can produce by using this particular biotechnology. Especially, first we will discuss very briefly and elaboratively about the agriculture. Then friends, we will read very briefly about the medicines. In case of agriculture, let me summarize you first, then I will start explaining one by one briefly and elaboratively. So first one, by using this particular biotechnology, we have produced several genetically modified plants. Why? What's the reason why we have produced several genetically modified plants? The reason behind that, improvement in the nutritional quality. Suppose example, vitamin A enriched rice. What do we call this, my friends? We call it this as a golden rice. Hello. What do we call it as, my friends? Golden rice. You know what is the specialty of this particular rice? It is a rich of vitamin A, and especially friends, the people who consume the rice which is having more amount of the vitamin A, they will be protect themselves exclusively from the eye related diseases like gerophthalmia, even night blindness also. Anyway, we will discuss briefly about that. Even biotechnology plays a key role in the better nitrogen fixation also. Most important one, plant can protect themselves. See, we the animals, whenever we are facing a lot of adverse condition, we will try to protect ourselves. Same way, friends, the plants are also, whenever they are exposing to the several stress condition, they also has to be tolerated, especially cold stress, drought stress, salt stress, heat stress. So friends, in order to protect itself from various stress conditions, there are lot of proteins to be inserted in the plant body, which will help the plant body in the adverse condition especially. And we are going to read about pest resistant plants. We are going to read very briefly about this. Anyway, let's start. So friends, these are all the top 10 genetically modified plants which are basically produced by using this particular rDNA technology, that is soy, corn, rice, tomatoes, potatoes, cotton seeds and different things. We're gonna discuss one by one briefly. So friends, let's try to understand the first and most important one. I want every one of you focus. If you find any kind of doubt, friends, immediately ask me. The first one is what? Pest resistant plants. Especially the cotton plant. Listen everyone, my friends. Especially the cotton plant is highly infected with the different kinds of worms. The worms like, everyone focus my friends, worms like army worm, the worms like a cotton worm. There are different type of worms used to affect the cotton plant. And friends, all these worms are belongs to a category called as lepidopterans. Okay, they all belongs to the family called lepidopterans, and they use it to infect the cotton plants at a high scale. As a result, what happened friends, because this particular worms are affecting the cotton plants, there will be a great reduction in the yield of that particular cotton plants. In order to prevent what friends, listen to me carefully, in order to prevent the attack of all these worms, what the biotechnologist did, biotechnologist introduced a specialized protein or a specialized toxin. What do we call that friends? That is what do we call the BT toxin. And friends, from where they have isolated this particular BT toxin, everyone please kindly keep it in your mind. Friends, this particular BT toxin exclusively prepared from a particular bacteria. What do we call that particular bacteria, friends? We call that particular bacteria as a Bacillus thuringiensis. What is that, friends? We called it as a Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria. And now, what the biotechnologists did? They have taken this particular bacteria, and from that particular bacteria, they have isolated a gene, and this gene undergo the process of transcription translation, and they have produced a protein. What is the name of that particular protein? Friends, the name of the protein, we called it as a cry protein. Why we have given name of the protein as a cry protein, friends? Because name of this particular gene is what, friends? Cry gene. And friends, I want you people to remember one more important point. That is, there are n number of cry genes are there, friends. Cry gene 1A, cry gene 2B, cry gene 3C. There are n number of types of cry genes are there. Friends, what the people did? First, biotechnologist taken the bacteria, and from that particular bacteria, they have isolated a gene, and they have given the name of the gene as a cry gene, and that particular cry gene given rise to the protein we call cry protein. And friends, what the people did? They have kept this particular cry protein. Where they kept the cry protein? Friends, they kept the cry protein on the leaf. On the leaf of that particular cotton plant. Now, friends, you try to understand the simple mechanism. Now, you will get one particular doubt. Sir, you said that this particular BT toxin is extremely toxic. Very, 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 very toxic. Now, you will get a doubt that, you can ask me that, sir, why this particular BT toxin cannot kill the plant itself? Why it cannot kill this particular plant? Because it is introduced into the plant. Now, you have to understand, this particular BT toxin, if it wants to be active, always, it require alkaline pH. It is alkaline pH. So you can easily remember one common point. What is that common point? The BT toxin, my friends, it is always, all the time inactive. Always keep it in your mind. It is all the time inactive. If it wants to be active, inactive means what, my friends? It will be in a form called as a protoxin form. What form, friends? Protoxin. So BT toxin exists as an inactive protoxin. So in the plant body, it cannot show any kind of a effect at all. Now friends, suppose example, this is the plant leaf. On the plant leaf, the BT toxin was accumulated since it is a protoxin and inactive toxin. Suppose example, when the worm attacked, when the worm attacked that particular plant, the particular leaf, what happened, friends? This particular cry protein will be released. But what is the point here? If the cry protein wants to be active, if the cry protein want to show their action, what do they require? Cry protein, in order to show their action, it require the alkaline pH. Now, from where we can maintain this alkaline pH? Actually, friends, all these particular lepidopterans, tobacco worm, bud worm, army worm, they are all basically in their mouth, in their saliva, they basically contain alkaline pH. So because of that particular alkaline pH, what is going to happen, friends? Now that particular toxin, once enter into the alkaline pH, that is the gut of that particular worm, now this, which is a protoxin form, friends, it is completely converted into the toxin form. As a result, it will be activated and it will destroy that all particular insects. So that's why we can call it as a insecticidal protein. Do not forget that at all. So BT toxin exists as a inactive protoxin, and on ingestion of it by insect, it can be converted into the active form. Why, friends? It is going to be converted into the active form exclusively due to alkaline pH of the gut, and it will solubilize the crystals. And one other important point, the activated toxin binds to the surface of the midgut epithelial cells and create the pores, nothing but swellings, and it will cause the lysis, which leads to the death of that particular insects. Do not forget that particular point at all. Now, what is the speciality of this particular BT toxin? It is synthesized from a gene called as crizin, and these are all the type of crizins. Okay, so friends, you can easily understand the overview of this particular picture. So this is the bacteria. From this particular bacteria, I have isolated a gene. What is the name of that particular gene? Crizin. Now I have isolated it and I have cloned it into multiple times and I have introduced it into the plant. Now this plant is rich of what? Cry protein. Why it cannot show the action on the plant body? Because in the plant body, it is in the pro form, which we called protoxin. Once it got attacked by this particular worms, then immediately what happened? The protoxin converted into active toxin, then only it is going to show their major action. Okay, so I have given briefly and elaborately the information you can understand. Then the most important technique, which we have to read very briefly for the examination point of view, friends, that is the pest resistant plants. Name itself indicating na, we have to make the plant without any, we have to make the plant in such a way that the plant has to be resisted towards any kind of the pest related infections. And friends, please remember, however, cotton plant is going to get infected greatly by worms, there are several nematodes, friends. That particular nematodes are going to affect. What they are going to affect? They are going to affect the tobacco plants. Majorly, they are going to affect the tobacco plants. Among all the nematodes, one of the major nematodes that can continuously affect the tobacco plant is what, friends? Melanogaster incognita. It is going to affect the root of the tobacco and causing destruction of that particular roots. Now, the point you have to understand, how can we destroy this particular nematode and how can we make this particular tobacco plant to become a pest resistant plants? So first of all, you have to understand one more common point. What is that particular common point you have to understand? First of all, how does this particular Melanogaster is going to show their action? Friends, listen to me carefully. This is the Melanogaster. How it is going to show their action? First, it will release its gene, right? Now the gene of that particular Melanogaster nematode, it will undergo the transcription, produce the mRNA. And that particular mRNA translate and it give rise to what, friends? Protein. Now that particular protein synthesized by the Melanogaster, it can destroy the root of tobacco plant. What, my friends? They are going to completely destroy the root of the tobacco plants. This is what happens when the Melanogaster enter inside. Now, if we want to stop this particular action, everyone has to listen to me carefully. What we have to do? We have to block the process of translation, which means we should not allow, my friends, what we should not allow? We should not allow the mRNA not to translate into protein. So we have to block each and everything at the RNA level. So we are blocking the mechanism of RNA. So that's why we called as RNA interference technology. In short, friends, we can call it RNAi. Keep it in your mind. Do not forget that. How we are going to do this particular thing? So first of all, what did I tell you, friends? What did I tell you? What we have to block? We have to block the mRNA not to be translated into protein. For that, what exactly we have did? Listen to me. So first, we have taken a particular, from that particular nematode, what we did, friends? We have isolated a gene. From the nematode, we have isolated a gene. After isolating a gene from the nematode, we have introduced that particular gene where in the vector. And friends, what is vector? Vector is the one which can carry the gene, which can carry the gene to the desired area. So friends, what is that? What's the vector we used here? Agrobacterium tumefaciens. We have taken Agrobacterium tumefaciens as a vector, and in that particular vector we have introduced the nematode specific gene. Then that particular nematode specific gene which we kept in the Agrobacterium vector, finally we introduced it into the host plant. Now what do we call this particular plant? Now we just modified. Why? Because we have introduced a nematode specific gene. That's why we call it that particular plant as a transgenic plant. Now friends, whatever the DNA that we have introduced into the host plant, now it will produce both the sense RNA as well as anti-sense RNA. And friends, what are the speciality of this particular sense and anti-sense, friends? What's the speciality of the sense and anti-sense? Sense and anti-sense, they are basically, friends, what we can say, complementary with each other. So since they are complementary with each other, friends, they are going to synthesize a double-stranded RNA. You have to understand one unique point. What's the double-stranded RNA is doing? The double-stranded is RNA is silencing the mRNA, which means it never ever allow the mRNA not to express. What, friends? It never ever allow the mRNA not to express continuously. It will block their complete translation process. Now, when nematode infest the plant, so now what happened? Now in the plant body, what is there? In the tobacco plant, double-stranded RNA is there. What is the speciality of double-stranded DRNA? Double-stranded RNA, it will block the protein synthesis. How? Try to understand. Okay, now finally, the plant basically contains double-stranded RNA, which we produced from the sense and antisense RNA. Now listen to me very carefully. Now, nematode attacked the tobacco plant. When the nematode attacked the tobacco plant, what nematode will do? Nematode will release the gene. Now, once the nematode release the gene, now the gene undergo the transcription, it produce the mRNA. If that particular nematode mRNA, what, my friends? If this particular nematode mRNA synthesize the protein, that protein kill the plant. What we have to do? Now, we should not allow this particular mRNA not to be translated into protein. Just keep it in your mind. Now, the point is very clear. Now, this particular mRNA has to be blocked. It has to be silenced. So, how it is going to be silenced, friends? By this particular double-stranded RNA. And this process only, what do we call, friends? RNA interference. So, this is how we can make the pest-resistant plants, especially, friends, tobacco plants, right? Friends, that's all for now. I hope the discussion is useful. We will meet in the next class with the another applications. Okay? Thank you all. Thank you very much.